Hello people, in this video, let us look at hyphema. So this can also be written as hyphema, okay? So there can be either spellings with the A, without the A. Basically, what is ema? Anything blood, right? Like anemia, E, all that, right? So this you know. So you, hyph, what is hyph here? Hype, something down, hypo, hype type of a thing. Because we have seen hype. Hypopyon, right? That was same thing like in anterior chamber you will have pus, but here hyphema you have blood. So what is this anterior chamber? Let's look at that. So here you have the eye. So basically this is the cornea and this is the lens, right? In between these two you have the anterior chamber. That is in front of the iris you have the anterior chamber. Now in this anterior chamber blood is accumulating, right? So in this anterior chamber, that is here, blood is accumulating. So posterior chamber is here, guys, behind the iris, but we are not talking about that. Between this iris and cornea, the gap, whatever is the anterior chamber, here blood is accumulating because of gravity is down only. So this is hype, H-Y-P, hypema, okay, blood. So is this clear, guys? Hypema, what hypema is, concept you have understood, right? So basically, in this video, we are looking at this hyphema. So here you have a photo. You can see the blood here, right? So you can see that how blood has accumulated in the anterior chamber. So that is between the cornea and the iris, right? In the anterior chamber, below it has accumulated. So let us look at the definition. Hyphema is the blood in anterior chamber. It can be due to a lot of things. Let us look at the reasons later. First of all, it is blood in the anterior chamber. Anterior chamber is where? In eye, correct? Now, let us look at another definition here. Hyphema. So, it's collection of blood in the anterior chamber. Okay, it can occur because of lot of things. Again, let's keep that waiting. So, again, hyphema. Blood in anterior chamber is called hyphema. Okay. So, now let us try to look at the causes. Go back here. Look at the causes here. Trauma following a surgery. So first thing they are listing is what? Trauma. Then as a complication of the surgery, early complication usually of the cataract surgery, it will be HZO, herpes zoster, right? O is what? Some ophthalmia, something to do with the eye. Gonococcal iridocyclitis, because of gonococcus. Then blood discrasiasis, clotting disorder, intraocular tumors. So, blood discrasias means something abnormal with the blood. So, these are the causes. Let us make a separate slide for the causes, okay? Causes. So, what are the causes we have seen? So, they are saying trauma, okay? So, hyphema, causes. So, look at this trauma, right? So, trauma to the iris, ciliary body, blood vessels. So, injury to the iris, especially the angle recession. What is this angle recession? Look at this. Angle recession refers to rupture of ciliary body. So, let us just see this. So, they are talking about something here. Ciliary body is here. So, some trauma here, ciliary body to the or to the iris. Okay. So, the first thing you should remember is trauma, right? Ocular injuries. Fine. Then, coming to the next one, post-operative. Post-operative is the next cause. Post-operative, from where did the blood come now? Obviously, after surgery, it has come. So, here, especially what surgeries they do on eye? Cataract surgery, like small incision cataract surgery. This can be an early complication, okay? After glaucoma surgery also, it is possible. So, this is post-operative. Hyphema, post-operative hyphema, okay? Then, what else are the causes of hyphema? Herpes zoster iritis, okay? So, HZO, herpes zoster ophthalmicus, they can say. Then you have gonococcal iritis, so because of the bacteria, gonococci. Herpes zoster is what? Virus, okay? Then, blood discrasias, okay? Some problem with the blood clotting disorder, etc. Then, intraocular tumors. So, tumors also can cause hyphema. So, what are those tumors? Like retinoblastoma, angioma, In retinoblastoma, 1% chance only that there will be hyphema. Then this can also be spontaneous. Okay, spontaneously these blood vessels might rupture. So let's put that here next to trauma. Okay, spontaneously something can happen and there can be hyphema. Tumors of iris also can have hyphema, guys. So this actually should go here with the tumors. Neoxanthoendothelioma. Look at that name. Neoxanthoendothelioma. This is tumor of iris. Even in this, it can be there. Okay, what is this tumor if you want to know? It is a rare fleshy vascular lesion seen in babies. It may cause recurrent hyphema. It is treated with x-rays or steroids. So recurrent hyphema. So this word now only we are seeing, right? Recurrent hyphema. Then non-granulomatous uveitis also, there can be hyphema, like in the UGH syndrome, that is the uveitis plus glaucoma hyphema. Okay. So now you have understood the causes. What are the causes, guys? Tumors, trauma, spontaneously it can occur. After surgery, it can be there. Then what else you saw? Some blood dyscrasiasis, clotting disorder. What else? What else? What else? Non-granulomatous uveitis. Yes. So, in all these cases, herpes zoster, some viral infection, some bacterial infection like gonococci, all these cases there can be hyphema. So we are done with the causes. Okay. So from where will the blood come, guys? Where do you think? So usually it can be the conjunctival vessels or the scleral vessels. Okay. Or from the root of iris, they are saying. Let us look at all these. So some blood vessels of what? Conjunctiva. Conjunctiva is somewhere here, right? Conjunctiva. So this is conjunctiva, then the sclera, right? The green is the sclera in this diagram, right? So yeah, the green is the sclera. So from the scleral vessels, right? Or the conjunctival vessels, or the iris, right? That's what they are saying, root of iris. Guys, read about this more from the textbook, okay? So guys, this hyphema can lead to blood staining of cornea. See, it is associated with hyphema. So if there is hyphema and intraocular pressure, there can be blood staining of cornea. Blood staining of cornea is associated with hyphema and raised intraocular pressure. So basically, blood staining of cornea, where is the cornea? See, first of all, where is blood accumulating? Here, in the anterior chamber. So that can do blood staining of cornea, right? So the cornea can get blood stained, okay? Guys, let us look at traumatic hyphema. Usually this may be trivial or serious. Okay. So, they are saying here that hospital admission is advised if the hyphema occupies more than half of the anterior chamber. Okay. And then they will observe the patient because there can be danger of secondary hemorrhage. So, usually this hyphemas, you know, mostly they get absorbed or spontaneously, the body absorbs this blood spontaneously, okay? And sometimes they don't even need treatment. So basically, if there is raised intraocular pressure, they will give some acetazolamide, hyperosmotic agents, okay, to lower this intraocular pressure. So if you remember, in diuretics, we have studied acetazolamide here, see? It is a carbonic anhydrase inhibitor. Right, it is a carbonic anhydrase inhibitor. It's a weak diuretic. So they are going to treat with that and some hyperosmotic agents. Hyperosmotic agents will be like osmotic diuretics, mannitol, isosorbide, glycerol, etc. So guys, what are we looking at? The treatment for traumatic hyphema, right? So some hyphemas, how to treat? So basically, they can be trivial. Most of them will get absorbed spontaneously. They don't need treatment. If it fills less than half of anterior chamber, usually it will refill, reabsorb itself. So if it is more extensive, then what it can do, it can lead to pupillary block or trabecular block. Okay. So then there can be glaucoma, increased intraocular pressure, right? Because of all this trabecular block. So what they are saying is admission to hospital is advised if the hyphema occupies more than half of the anterior chamber. Okay. And then they will observe the patient because there can be danger of secondary hemorrhage. So they will give a patch to the affected eye. The patient will be made to rest in such a way that the head is elevated, right? So more blood won't flow to the head. So the head is elevated. So they will treat the person with sodium edetate to prevent re-bleeding. So what does the sodium edetate do? So sodium edetate, right, So basically all these are anticoagulants. So they will prevent the clot of blood. So this is, yes, an anticoagulant. But here they have written it is to prevent re-bleeding. So not sure of that. But anyways, now anti-glaucoma therapy, if intraocular pressure is raised, we already told you. Right. So in that case, what will you give? Acetazolamide, hyperosmotic agents. So this we already told you. Right. Then. So in the treatment, we are continuing, guys. So we are here now. If the pain is unrelieved or is there is a threat that it will stain the cornea, evacuation of the central clot is carried out with a two-way aspiration cannula. So there is some two-way aspiration cannula. So let us see how they do that. Two-way aspiration cannula. This may be accompanied by glaucoma filtering surgery if the intraocular pressure cannot be controlled medically. So if they cannot control the intraocular pressure, then to prevent glaucoma, then they will do some glaucoma filtering surgery. So they are not able to control the intraocular pressure with this acetazolamide, hyperosmotic agents, etc. Then there's also something here called as paracentesis should be done to drain the blood. Hollow needle to remove fluid or gas. Paracentesis. Hollow needle to remove fluid or gas. Perforation they will do. Okay. Guys, let's just look at this irrigation aspiration cannula. What did they say? Double? Some word they used here, no? Some term they use here. Two-way aspiration cannula, right? It's very small font for you. Two-way aspiration cannula. So look at that here. Is this the one? Aspiration cannula this is. There's one more photo here. Irrigation and aspiration. Yeah, two-way irrigation and aspiration cannula. So that's what probably they are referring to, guys. Okay, so what are we looking at? The aspiration cannula. So it is two-way aspiration, irrigation and aspiration cannula. Okay. So aspiration of hymphema is an indication for use of this two-way aspiration, irrigation. Aspiration, irrigation. Irrigation and aspiration cannula. What is this one? Simcoe irrigation aspiration cannula. This is the original model they are saying. Okay. So guys, is this fine? So we have spoken of the treatment. So guys, just remember, okay. So head elevated, all that. Let's just take a recap of this. Hyphema is nothing but the collection of blood in anterior chamber of eye, right? Because of gravity, it will be down. So you can see that here. Because of gravity, it will be here. So basically, what are the causes? Trauma. Guys, trauma to iris, ciliary body, globe rupture, foreign body also can cause trauma. It can be a complication after cataract surgery, after glaucoma surgery. It can be because of herpes zoster, ophthalmicus, gonococcal infection it can be because of some blood disorder, some clotting disorder this person has. Then intraocular tumor, retinoblastomas, angiomas. Guys, listen, okay, tumor of iris also. It can be a spontaneous thing that is happening because of some condition called as rubeosis iridis, okay. Then it can be also seen in non-granulomatous uveitis, okay. Then this can lead to blood staining of cornea. So how will you manage this? Basically, if it is a trivial, if it is less than half of anterior chamber, it can get absorbed by itself. If it is more than that, they will admit the person, keep the head elevated, right? So that the blood will go down, right? Not more into the head. Then they will, what else will they do? So there is a danger of secondary hemorrhage. They are saying there can be trabecular block, etc., which can lead to raised intraocular pressure. So to lower the intraocular pressure, they will give acetazolamide, hyperosmotic agents. What will happen, guys, if they leave the intraocular pressure to increase? It can lead to glaucoma, right? Optic nerve damage. So then what else? They will give sodium edetate. They have written here that to prevent re-bleeding. Okay. Then what else? They will do some, there are other options like two-way aspiration cannula, okay, so that they can If there is a threat of blood staining to the cornea, evacuation of the central clot, they will do evacuation of the clot using this two-way aspiration cannula, right? Then they can also do something called as paracentesis to drain the blood, okay? So this is the irrigation aspiration cannula. It has some specific name called as Simcoe, okay? So I think this much is enough for now in hyphema. So hope you have understood hyphema, and what else you want to know about it, please read the textbook for more information. Bye bye.